The issues and views discussed on the Roll Call Room podcast are the sole opinions of the guest or host and do not reflect the views of any agencies or government offices. Persons discussed on the show may be fictional or exaggerated for comedic purposes. The Roll Call Room podcast is not responsible for any injuries sustained while listening, to include but not limited to busting a gut, laughing until you cry, nausea, crying until you laugh, alcohol poisoning, and a sudden and intense dislike for those named Steve. Please use caution while operating a motor vehicle, as the podcast is not liable for any traffic violations or damage. This podcast is rated explicit, and listener discretion is advised. Epstein didn't kill himself.
Chicken sandwich. They got a pickle. Listen to me. They got a pickle on the chicken sandwich that tastes like chicken. The pickle tastes like chicken. You hear me? It's a buttermilk bread.
It's hard not to eat.
It's buttermilk bread. And the bread's so soft that it just melts in your mouth. And I got the spicy chicken, Sister Gray.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Roll Call Room podcast. And now your host, Nick and Mike. Epstein didn't kill himself.
Bad boys, what you want, what you want, what you gonna do?
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, settle down. Roll call is in session. I like that. Roll call is in session. I like that. It's like at work.
It is.
Usually it's...
All right, pipe down now.
Pipe down now, you fucking vermins.
Listen up, eh?
What'd you think of that opening?
It's hilarious.
Yeah, I found it. I found it on YouTube. It's a guy that just had the Popeye's chicken sandwich, and he was going fucking berserk with his wife, like explaining how fucking awesome the chicken sandwich was.
The guy was like dead serious about it too.
He was passionate.
He was waiting for affirmation from his wife. I hear you. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She's like, she goes, it's hard not to hear you. I want to put the video up because they're in their bedroom and he's jumping around on the bed like a 5-year-old. Like, hilarious.
Have you had one yet?
No.
Have
Me
you?
Me neither.
I kind of want to try it though. I like spicy chicken.
Is it spicy?
Spicy chicken. I don't know.
Because he said something about spicy chicken. I thought there was only one kind of chicken sandwich there.
Oh, I don't know.
Maybe
I
mean, they have two different kinds. I don't know.
It's a good question.
Would you go on duty?
I mean, yeah, early when they open before the roaches settle in.
Oh.
Like early in the morning. What?
Jesus.
What? It's true. You ever been on those places on alarm calls?
Yeah, but those are the fucking best places to eat, bro. I've gone on alarm calls and the kitchen is like fucking really nasty, but the food is good.
I don't want to get sued for defamation from these big name fucking agencies.
Popeye's is great.
I've been in a couple places and it is not very clean.
I think you could say that about any restaurant.
This one was pretty bad.
Well, I got to tell you... So we had a Chinese food place that we eat at by where I live.
Some young guy.
Okay. We've just lost all Asian fans. That's fantastic. So you've alienated last episode Russian or whatever accent you were trying to do.
I don't know.
Whatever it was terrible. So I've been eating at this Chinese food place since I moved down here from New York City. And I moved like 3 years ago to where I am now, and I found out that this place delivers to my house. So I was super excited. And then, of course, I've got to go on Facebook and I go on the top 10 worst restaurants where I live.
Number one.
36 critical violations in the last 12 months, including when the food inspector was doing the kitchen inspection. Mice were running over his feet. He put it in his inspection.
Oh, shit. That's disgusting.
I mean, I still eat there, though.
Yeah. Well, at least, in New York, they got that big-ass letter right on the window of the restaurants. Yeah, A, B, C, or D. No one ever looks at that.
I want to say that, New Yorkers, that's like a rite of passage. Like, if there's an F on the door, I think you almost have to try it.
Yeah.
You think? Yes.
I don't know. Most places are like D. I wonder how much they're paying off the code inspectors, though, to put it.
I wonder
putting their own A up there.
I wonder how many restaurants Detective Mario is able to eat at in New York City.
And he got promoted over. Sorry.
I just
Detective Sergeant Mario.
Detective Sergeant Mario.
Sergeant Detective Mario.
We just promoted you. I want to do a couple of shout outs from Twitter. At JFX41. You're awesome. Thank you. You've been nonstop plugging in the roll call room army.
Gracias.
Heather at Rocks for Leo's. We love
Heather.
Heather is awesome. She is awesome. Cassandra Beltran, girly girl. As always, you're always supportive. Tommy Boy 1957. You're super cool. Sergeant Ed, which is at Sergeant Ed 99. Super cool. He's the guy that made fun of you for not coming into the studio.
What up, Sarge?
So who else here? If I forget anybody, I will add you later on. Kathy and Rick, which is at Bullet Gifts. Check them out. They're really awesome. They've been super, super cool pushing us out on Twitter. Follow us on Twitter at Roll Call Room. Griff Girly Girl. Sorry, I called her Girly Girl. I just like your handle. Your handle is at Griff Girly Girl. That's so awesome. I just like saying it. So that's Twitter. We may have a couple of real big announcements from some sponsorships that we're looking at, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, hell yeah. We need fucking Chevy to get on here.
Okay.
Hello, Chevy, heartbeat of America. We need your endorsement.
All right. Yeah.
I need a fucking Suburban. I need a three.
You need a
third row.
Silverado.
And I need an RV that sleeps at least eight.
Okay. I'm over here looking for fucking coffee sponsors, and you're looking for fucking Chevy sponsors.
Hey, we can wrap it. We'll put, roll call room, wrap that shit around the RV. I'll drive it around town. I don't care.
I will fucking promote, sex toys at this point. I mean...
All right. Yeah, we're going to get to that point. That's on our agenda today.
Yeah, it is. I'm a little concerned.
Interesting.
I'm a little concerned.
Yeah. Especially when I call him hey, bro, I got some good material for today. Oh, yeah. What's that? Dildos.
Yeah, you did that this morning.
What is it? Okay.
I'm scared. I text you, I'm scared, but go ahead. That's how this relationship works.
I'm up for it.
It's fucking dead people. Okay? Shoot me your idea. So they're laying down, and then I flip them over.
I think I can get behind this.
I think I could do three fingers. So we're what? This is number six, seven? I don't even remember.
We're just coming up with fire in here.
I don't
every
know.
Day.
But it is blowing up. Folks from where Mike and I work constantly messaging us. We really appreciate it. Even the criticism. We welcome it as long as it's valid criticism.
It doesn't matter to me. I mean, my wife says worse to me. So
That's so true.
Listen, man, we appreciate the listeners, good and bad. And people are like, I got a text this morning. Oh, Commanders are really fucking with you guys. I'm like, it just means they're listening, man.
Yeah.
So fucking let them listen. Thanks for the views. Thanks for the listens.
And if you don't listen to any other episode, listen to Leaders. If you're a commander, not even from our agency, because you're talking less than 1%. I mean, less than a quarter of a percent is the problem. But if you're in a leadership position, you should be leading. You should be listening to that. We're going to put out several parts of leadership. But I do have to say, the folks that we work with, it's kind of interesting because people will send Mike and I a text message and say, well, are you talking about this person? Will you tackle? Listen, nothing that we discuss on this podcast, I'm not going to tell you to your face. I'm not a coward. I'm not going to hide behind a podcast and talk about you behind your back. I have good people that I work with. I have fantastic people I work with. My group that I work on is fantastic. We help each other out. There was some controversy about the last episode, not the last episode, the episode before that, that I told a story, and Nancy, who's on my group, dumped a call on me. If you're going to start that drama, I would prefer that you just delete or unsubscribe on whatever platform.
Steve, you dick.
Whoever, it's Steve. It's Steve.
That's a Steve move.
That's a Steve move. I have a fantastic group, and like all of you out there that are in law enforcement, there's some good people and there's some bad people. And fortunately, I work with 99.9% good people. Can people get better? Absolutely. But if I had an issue with somebody, I'm going to tell them flat out to their face. I'm not going to fucking hide behind a podcast.
They know that's how I roll.
Yeah.
So I ain't scared.
So since our last podcast, we had some news. We had Detective Mario on. And then shortly after that, the commissioner of police for NYPD has stepped down.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, and the unfortunate part is that it looks like the replacement's going to be another internal hire. Mm. So their problem with suicide and mental health for their officers just seems like it's just going to be just a vicious cycle. They're just not using the resources that they need to use to fix it. So it'll be interesting to see how that goes.
Yeah, they got a lot of issues going on up there, man. It's going to be a close eye on that, seeing how that unfolds.
Yeah, and your Montgomery County rant that you went on was very well.
MoCo.
Yeah, that was very, very well received. On Twitter, it was picked up several different times. It was retweeted a lot. Blue Lives Matter. And
hopefully Eldridge gets to listen to it. There's a special announcement in there for him. And Marcus Jones.
Yeah.
Which I did get someone to get back to me on that, Marcus Jones, chief.
Oh, did you?
Apparently used to be a cop's cop.
Really? What happened?
Mm-hmm. He got promoted and sold his soul to the devil. Typical.
Why do they do that?
Became one of the guys, drank the water, started doing stupid shit, and then started having enemies from within. So that's what happens, man. It ain't worth your soul, bro.
No.
You know? I don't know.
Have you heard from any of the guys over there how they're doing?
No, I haven't reached back out. I think I'll probably, you know, honestly, dude, I'm thinking about just driving up there, just doing like an off the air interview. You know, we got the capabilities now.
Yes, we do.
Might as well drive up
there. Yes, we do. Big announcement. We'll be going on the road doing interviews.
Yeah, TV, more to come.
Yeah. Anybody that wants us to interview them in Hawaii and can cover the airfare and hotels, we'd be more than happy to go there.
Yeah. We'll go wherever you want.
Wherever you want. So what else is going on, Mike?
It's Sunday, man. Sunday fun day. You know, my morning starts. It's interesting, man, because the baby got up super early this morning. So I was like, oh, fuck.
You know, how early is early?
I think he was like screaming at 6:30, 6:45, which is up early for him.
Which number out of the five was it?
That's the baby. The youngest
baby
one.
Baby. Yeah, the last one?
Yeah. So,
or almost the last one?
Really? Right. All right, exactly.
All right.
Better shut your mouth. Don't put that juju on me.
I'll put that tweet out right now.
Shout out to PG County. If you catch me on the Woodrow Wilson Bridge, you know what's up.
What the fuck? Wow.
We're good. We're very blessed with five. I'm good, bro.
Are you?
Yeah. I'm telling you, answer that 301 number if it calls you. You know what's up. But anyway, so that's how my morning started. So I said, let me get my coffee going, slow roll it, feeding them breakfast. We're hanging out, jamming to Bob Marley on the speakers in the house. Yeah, man, you know,
Bob Marley.
Three little buddies.
What?
Maybe. Shaba.
What was that?
Anyway, so then my boys start to wake up, my second grader and my kindergartner, and then they come down, and then I'm giving them, making them breakfast and egg. There it is. That's my Sunday jive right there.
Hey, bro, you want some pancakes, bro?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to have bacon, bro. 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 Does it look like we have fucking orange juice, bro?
Daddy, I want cereal. We don't have any more cereal. Bro. It's all gone.
Are you fucking kidding, bro? I'm making pancakes.
Hell yeah, dude.
I could just picture that.
That's my morning, dude. Wife beater on. Shorts.
There it is. There it is.
Just clean up your mess.
Be honest. You know? Were you wearing Crocs?
Yes.
I knew it.
The wool ones. Insulated, bro, because it's chilly. It's that time of year, dude. I got the black
on
black.
Hold on.
What do you mean, hold on? You're over here with this fucking hopscotch.
You have Crocs with...
Yeah, the wool in them that are insulated that make you warm in the winter. You can wear them all year round.
You're making fun of me with my Crocs.
Bro, you had dress socks on.
I had something going on earlier that day.
What? And you wore those Crocs?
Are
you a fucking deep fryer at KFC?
What am I going to do? Take those socks off and put new socks on? That's wasting socks. I would have wore socks for 2 hours. I don't know if you know, but I'm a cop. I can't afford to do laundry.
You were like, I'm going to get comfortable doing the podcast.
Oh, damn right. I had sweatpants on.
What do we have here? I got my favorite set of Crocs here. I'm going to put these bad boys on.
I am not looking forward to when we go like on camera because then I got to wear presentable shit. Like,
who says?
The way I looked the other day when we did the podcast, I looked homeless.
It's all right.
I was wearing Crocs. Man.
I give you money. So,
go ahead.
We're getting our breakfast on. Mm-hmm. And of course, they're all boys. So they're like, Dad, let me draw you a picture. Right?
Oh, boy.
So I said, okay, what you got? And he's like, I want to get this artwork, you know, and they're boys, man. So what do they draw? They draw a stick figure, right?
Oh, boy.
And I'm like, what is this? And they're like, he's peeing. He's pooping. He's farting.
Come on.
Those are his balls. I said that, right? And they're like,
choked on
and I'm like,
water.
Why does he have five balls? I don't know. And I'm like, dude, you got to destroy this stuff before your mother wakes up.
Would she flip out?
That's so inappropriate. Why are they? I'm like, they're boys.
And what happens when they're having alone time in the future?
Dude, they're boys. Listen,
that's what I'm saying. What is she? She's going to lose her mind.
She is going to lose their mind. Especially because they're good-looking boys, so forget about it, bro. They're gonna have to put bars on the window.
Well, you know, I was gonna save it for the next episode, but
that was my Sunday. So then I was just checking out a couple of the platforms, and I was like, all right, cool. So I reached out to poorly made police memes.
Yeah.
And you saw that I sent you the screenshot or whatever. So hopefully we can get something going because they were like, maybe we should do a podcast. I'm like, bro, this is what we do.
Yeah, we're already there.
We're already there, but we could do something together kind of thing. So hopefully they'll get back to me on that. Shout out to Poorly Made Police Memes. This shit is hilarious.
I love that. You said you got me onto it, and it's really
dude,
really
it's good. Crack. And it's so true. It's so true. But
I love it.
So yeah, so my buddy Jimmy and then his boy, my godson's birthday party was last night, and we went to a bowling alley out here, and then we went laser tag inside the bowling alley.
Oh
yeah. Black night, a clear
white moon, Warmer G was on. Hey, Mike.
Regulators.
Hey, guess what, man?
Yo, what up?
We are now available on YouTube.
Nice.
Yeah, so iTunes, Spotify, all your podcast outlets, and now YouTube.
Beautiful.
Pretty cool. So if you're at work and you can't listen to us on your regular podcast platform, go on YouTube. All of our episodes are going to be transmitted through the video, which is pretty cool.
Nice.
Yeah. All right. Folks, check us out on rollcallroom.com.
Rollcallroom.com.
You can email us at nick@rollcallroom.com or mike@rollcallroom.com. Check us out on Twitter @rollcallroom.
Facebook, Instagram, everywhere.
Check us out. Spread the word. Share.
So Jimmy, you know, he's like, hey, man, come to, you know, the birthday party, whatever. And he's like, you know, we're talking on the sideline and we're like, hey, man, he's like, your podcast is really good. It helps, you know, normal. Even though I'm not a cop, I get it because you know, your stories and things you share sounds like you guys are human beings. And I'm like,
totally.
Yeah, we're not fucking robots, bro. I mean, people don't understand, like, there is no special, we go through training and you got to earn it and all this other stuff and you get indoctrinated and police procedure and the law and stuff like that. But it's not like, I mean, we're just everyday regular people. We just, our job, our every days are your worst days.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And like that's why we have so many fucked up stories.
Yeah, exactly.
But, you know, I learned on Twitter, thanks to Heather, you know, it's a big drive for content like this, like Live PD.
Yes.
Live PD has
number
like
one show.
60 different Twitter handles. I can't keep track of all of them.
Yeah.
And the folks on there are like the loyalist fans.
Yeah.
So a big, huge shout out to Twitter fans. I mean, Live PD fans. We love you. Thank you for following us. Keep sharing us. We really appreciate it.
But everyone wants to know kind of what we do, and that's the thing. So, I mean, I don't know if you guys don't know this, because, and I started thinking about this earlier too. We need to like critique some of our material towards civilians, because we have a lot of civilian listeners that are not necessarily sworn.
Big time.
So they don't really understand our slang and our terms and stuff like that. And, you know, inside jokes. So it's important that we kind of include them, but there's a huge following of people that want to know more about what we do. So you can always do a ride along with your local municipality.
Yes.
I encourage you. You're fucking paying taxes, right? You're a tax paying person. Go ride along with the cops. Yeah. You got to do a quick waiver to sign your life away. You'll be fine. Eh. You'll be all right. 50-50 shot. But I mean,
you'll die happy.
Yeah. You'll know where your money's going.
Yeah.
So you might as well just go out there and ride along. Now, on the flip side of that, we'll have an episode that covers ride alongs with. Sorry for everyone I just set up out there. It's like, fuck, now we're going to get a line of people.
Yeah.
But they're doing like the Citizens Academy, and they're making big deals, and they're cutting cakes and stuff. And people love that shit, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's a lot of closet supporters that, you know, a lot more need to come out, because we need that. We need that kind of support.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. Ride-alongs are the best. I mean, I love doing ride-alongs. Just if you're going to do a ride-along, like limit your questions to stuff that's not fucking stupid, you know, like,
well, how do they know that though?
Yeah, but you don't get in the car and go, hey, have you ever shot anybody?
Yeah, they do.
They do that.
They do that.
You ever kill anybody?
So, So what's the craziest thing you've ever seen?
Yeah, you can tell me. You can tell me. You ever fuck anybody on duty?
Jeez.
There was a ride along once. It was fairly recent that the ride along went. The officer left their phone in the glove box, and the ride along
did hear
went
this
in,
story.
Huh?
I heard this story. Go ahead.
Yeah. The ride along was mad because the officer wouldn't take him out of the car when she went on calls, which it's their discretion. They're worried about your safety.
Right.
This dude went into the glove box and took her phone out and started going through her fucking phone. I'd have fucking went berserk, bro. That'd have been the end
like
of the ride along.
Computer trespass.
Yeah,
or something,
it is
bro.
Actually. It is. She didn't want to press charges.
Dude, that's crazy, man.
Could you imagine that?
I'd be like, the fuck are you doing?
I'd drive right back. I'd drive right back to headquarters.
I'd make him walk back.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even drive him back.
I would GH him.
I'd
like
out of my fucking car. Get out now.
I would GH him.
I don't care what complaint come down from that. That's unacceptable.
I'm just thinking about it. That'd be kind of cool where you like go to the passenger side and you go, get out of the car. And they're like, oh, what's up? And you go, I want to show you a special side of the car. And they're like, oh, what is it? And you go, come back here and check these out. They're custom made. And you put the handcuffs on, and then you put them in the back of the car and take them to booking. And they're like, what is this for? Oh, you're getting the full ride along experience.
This
is the booking process. Why are they taking pictures of me? It's cool. You're going to get a nice FBI number. Everything's going to be good.
That's good.
Why are they putting me in this cage?
It smells like shit in here.
Why are there six drunk guys in here?
I have to get completely naked in here and spread my cheeks. Yeah. That's a whole nother story.
And down
strip searchers are the worst. Fucking stink so bad, man. This one guy we brought in, he had crack on him, and he ripped his toenail off and chewed it.
What?
Yeah, he ripped his big toenail off and shoved it in his mouth, started chewing it.
Why?
Because he's fucking crazy. I don't know.
That's disgusting.
I was like, oh, fuck.
How many times have you almost thrown up in the search room when they bring them into booking? I've had a couple of close calls.
Twice.
Yeah.
Like twice legit where I had to have them pop the door and let me back into the garage. Yeah. It was so bad.
I've had that.
I can't do it. Hey, pop the door. Let me back out.
Pop it. Yeah.
It's so bad. In the summer.
Yeah.
In the summer. It's the worst.
I was in field training, and it was with RS. And I think I told the story on
another fan
one.
Of the show, by the way.
Yeah, I know. Super cool. FTO. I love him. So RS made me fucking lock this guy up that was homeless. and he would.
They always have so much shit with them, dude.
Anyway, well, that was at the time where you didn't have to take their shit with you. You could just
trust
leave
me. It'll
shit.
Be here when it'll you get be out. Here. Let's nobody, just leave it right here.
Nobody wants your 16 fucking plastic bags.
Baby wipes.
Yeah. And inside of the bags are like fucking doll heads and fucking doll feet and shit. And you're like, why are you saving all of this shit?
Fucking chicken bones in here, man. This is trash. This is trash.
My favorite part about the homeless situation is when they have like good luggage. Like,
yeah, Samsonite.
And if you're homeless, do you really trespass?
Are their phones nicer than yours?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I've seen homeless people have iPhones.
Yeah. And tablets.
Tablets. Yeah. Yeah. Because I've gone to like places that are open 24 hours, like CVS.
Yeah, and they're in
at
there.
2 a.m. Yeah. They're charging their cell phone, and I had to stop myself because I'm like, "You're in here for what?" And they're like, "My cell phone died," and I'm like, "Who are you calling? Are you calling another homeless person to see if it's
let's go
if,
hang out
if there's
park.
Better real estate across town? Like,
dude.
What are you calling them for? Hey, I got a good spot.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah."
So I was saying, like in that episode one or two, I can't even remember. I took a guy. He had been on the street for so long. He hadn't taken a shower in at least a year.
Ugh.
And they took his boots off. And what he did was during the winter, he would take plastic bags and tie them around to keep it insulate your feet. I actually took that idea also from homeless people. And they cut the plastic bag off, which he freaked the fuck out because I guess you can't find plastic bags out on the street. And he freaked the fuck out. But when they took it off, his socks became one with his foot. So when they went to go take the sock off, it had disintegrated.
Yeah.
And then the particles went into the air and I could feel it floating in the air. And I had to cover.
You're like, oh, fuck,
dude.
Open the door. Open it.
I did. I was like,
let
pop
me
the
out.
Door,
let me out. Let me
door.
Out.
But the particles were like, by the time I got to the door, I was breathing in his fucking disintegrated socks. I tasted that sock for two fucking days.
That's disgusting.
Dude.
That's fucking disgusting.
I had Chipotle and I tasted his fucking socks.
Gosh,
holy shit. Yeah. On that note,
first break.
We're going to take a break.
What are you taking? Yes.
Yeah, buddy.
Turn that shit up.
I got to record stuff. Song.
I love that song, dude.
That was a good break.
Does he say Teenage Wasteland?
Yeah, I think so.
Teenage Wasteland. There it is.
Oh my god. Yeah, before the break, man, I wanted to I knew I was going somewhere with the chicken sandwich thing.
Fucking yeah, because they just had a murder.
Yeah, the people are going nuts.
Schmerlin. Shocker.
They murked out a guy for fucking
he
chicken
cut the,
sandwich.
Apparently people are like, it's not just a chicken. He
what
cut
is it?
The line. He cut the line.
So that warrants you to kill somebody.
Yes.
So
justifiable homicide.
So you're at the funeral home for Uncle Barry and you're around.
I mean,
and they're like, oh, what'd he die of? He got fucking shivved for a chicken sandwich.
Yeah.
Where the pickle tastes
fucking
like the
chicken.
Chicken
sandwich, dude.
Fucking, what a do you fucking, put that on your tombstone?
Fucking yard bird, man.
What the fuck?
Savages.
Seriously?
Bro. Savages.
Chick-fil-A has chicken sandwiches 7 days a week.
Yeah.
It's not.
Cut the line, Mo. Cut the line.
Bro.
Disrespect, man. There's, disrespect.
There's nothing
perpetrating.
More no. 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 Nobody dies for a chicken sandwich. That's just stupid.
Someone did.
That's
Popeye
stupid.
Should pay for the fucking funeral.
That's stupid.
Why not? They should pay for it.
What's wrong with you, Popeyes? Get your shit together.
Wasn't them. It's not their fault.
But yes, I'm sure because they create
sure
this
100
panic.
People pulled their phones out and fucking recorded the whole thing.
You know, and the thing is we got to fucking pick this dude's body up. Like,
yeah.
Like, we ain't got enough other shit to do. Like, imagine being the officers that respond to fucking Popeyes as a dead guy in the fucking...
Yeah, bleeding out. Yeah.
And you know that store, you know that restaurant wanted to open up right away. Like, they were fucking bitching to the detectives, like, how long is this going to be?
Yeah.
How long is this going to be?
Yeah.
I got three chicken in the deep
Meanwhile,
fryer.
Some dude's dead with a fucking blanket over him in the lobby.
That's happened before. I've been to homicides and business.
They always come up. How long is this going to... It's a fucking bank just got robbed. Oh. Is this going to be an all-day event?
Are you guys going to wrap this up?
Well, hopefully this isn't the only bank in this fucking state. Maybe you can go somewhere else, buddy.
Unbelievable, bro.
Savages, man. Savages.
So, you messaged me earlier.
Yeah, dildos.
And, I know I'm going to regret this, but you were going somewhere with this.
Well, it's funny because it's always hilarious stories because on the street, you always have these incidences that occur. And then you kind of share them with your squad mates. Like, dude, you can't believe this shit.
Yeah.
Like, you're not going to believe
this. Oh, yeah.
This just happened.
Oh, yeah.
And you're like, ha, ha, ha. You know, that's hilarious.
Typically, it's DOAs.
Depends.
Yeah.
Some of the ones that we've been on, the Pizza Hut guy.
Oh, shit. About that. Was I your supervisor then?
No, we were in the community outreach unit together. We were in the outreach unit together, and I jumped on the DOA because I was new to the unit.
That's right. You were like,
and I was like,
oh,
it's in my area. It's a DOA. Who cares?
And it was
you're like, bro, we don't do DOAs anymore. We do proactive.
You were fucking gun home.
Drug stuff.
And you regretted it.
I'm like, yeah, it was. I didn't know he was going to die with a fucking sock on his dick.
Well, you got to tell the full story, bro. Like, we get a call for service for a DOA.
You tell it best. You tell it.
It's in a predominantly Hispanic neighborhood, super hardworking neighborhood.
Was there like 14 people in the apartment?
It was four.
Okay.
Jesus. Christmas. All right.
I couldn't tell. There was bed sheets that divided the rooms.
All right. Ice detective. Jesus Christ. So we get a call for
Not
service.
Spreading hate. I'm spreading facts, but go ahead.
All right. We had a call for service. This guy, he's DOA, his roommates that he lives with, there's four dudes living in the apartment. There's not a living room or a dining room. They have all been made into bedrooms. These guys are hardworking guys.
Yeah.
The guy that passed away was a Domino's pizza delivery guy that worked overnight.
Pizza Hut.
Sorry. Oh, same shit. They both taste like shit.
All right.
unless you guys want to sponsor us. So we walk in and the guy is in his bed in what would be the living room when you walk into the apartment. The guy's eyes are open and they're staring at a bedroom door across the room. And he's got one hand underneath the covers and one outside of the covers.
So hold on. So when they call us, people got to understand this. When they call us to DOAs, it's like, oh, it's a DOA. So we go in there kind of like to the mood, even though we're like laughing and jerking off and grab assing before to the call on the way to the call. Then we get out and then we change
Super
our tone
respectful.
To be like somber,
Super
like, hey, sorry for your loss. Yeah. Like, you know, we match the tone going in, but then we're like, holy fuck, is that guy's eyes open? Is he staring at us?
And
what is he looking at?
It was super creepy.
Yeah.
Because
the roommate was the guy who called was really fucked up.
Yeah. Because
he was
this
like
is
really
happened.
Distraught.
Yeah. Because this is what happened. He wakes up in the morning to go to work for his morning shift. And he sees the guy there, but it's dark. So he thinks that the guy is asleep. Yeah. So he leaves the apartment. He comes back from work and he sees him still in bed. And he's like, maybe he's not feeling well.
Yeah, yeah.
And he goes into his bedroom and he wakes up the next morning to go to work again.
Yeah.
And the guy's still in bed.
Yeah. For like 2 days.
For two days.
DOA.
2 days.
This guy's like business as usual around him.
So those of
man,
you,
Jose is really tired, man.
That Pizza Hut delivery is really knocking him out. And what was creepy was his uniform was right next to the bed.
Yeah.
And it still had his shirt with his name tag on. It was super creepy.
It was.
And so guy's been there dead for 2 days. And those of you that have never been around dead bodies, stuff starts to get stiff. It's just the way that life is. It's the way the human body works. So he got stiff. So Mike over here decides, I'm going to be super cop and takes the call for service.
Yeah.
Well, we always have to inspect the body and make sure that it's not foul play, that somebody didn't stab him or shoot him and shoved him in his bed and put the covers over him. So Mike grabs the blanket and rips it off the guy. And the guy's got a sock around his male member.
Strong.
Yeah.
and then his hand is wrapped around that sock. And
rigor mortis is already set in.
Rigor mortis had set in. So he was basically holding the Atari joystick, basically. And the detective comes on scene, a super cool guy, and he's like, did you flip the body? Uh-huh. And Mike's like, I'm not fucking touching that thing. And the detective's like, you need to fucking flip that
thing. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mike flips this guy, hand and all, flips him over to look on his back, no trauma, no nothing, and has to flip him back over. When they zipped him up in the bag,
still like that.
He was still grabbing on to his sock and his joystick. It was terrible. Yeah.
It was terrible. Great was when Sarge gets on scene and he's like, is that a sock? Yeah. He's like, what's with this? Is that a sock?
Is that a sock? Is he grabbing a sock? And what we discovered was that the guy had died of a heart attack while he was having me time staring at his roommate's door.
He had a bunch of other pre-existing shit that he had going on, but he was taking pills from like El Salvador.
Fucking El Salvador.
Yeah, that's not really
terrible. On the box it said approved. Heart medication. Like it just said heart medication on the box. So they probably sent him over like fucking vitamin C.
Yeah.
And he thought he was taking his heart meds. But what was creepy was he was looking at his friend's door while he was taking care of business. Like, you don't think to yourself as you leave for work, Jose is probably like, this is weird. Dude, his eyes were open.
Dude, I had one. It was pretty bad. It was in the high-rise apartment building. The guy was the maintenance guy. Hadn't showed up to work for a week.
Oof.
Right? So I was like, so me and a guy, he's not here anymore. He actually got indicted and left the country.
But, okay.
We get up there and I'm like, there he is, the guy going to the back bedroom. He's face down in the pillows, right? He's like 60 years old. And I'm like, he's dead. So I tell this guy, I'm like, hey, man, we got to flip him, And he's like, nah, I ain't doing that shit.
Mm.
I'm like, dude, we have to. We have to notate in our report.
Yeah.
Like, it could be a big problem if we don't do this. Dude, it was like 90 fucking degrees. And the guy didn't turn on the AC at all.
No.
Yeah, it was smoking hot.
Dude.
Stinking. He wasn't starting. He wasn't like falling apart or anything, but it was really bad.
He was bubbled.
He was heavy as shit.
Yeah.
And the guy only ate fried food.
Ugh.
Like there was nothing but fried foods in the house. Like the fried pans.
Lividity was a fucking mess.
Dude,
I bet
it was a mess. So, crime scene technician guy comes out and he's like, "Oh, where's the body?" And I'm like, "It's in the back." Meanwhile, I'm like sitting in the living room waiting for fucking our body transport service to show up.
Yeah.
And he's like, I'm going to take a couple pictures. And I'm like, all right, yeah, do your thing, dude. He comes back. He's like, oh, I'm all done. And he leaves, right? I'm like, oh, okay.
That's weird.
So I had already saw the body laying face down, and we flipped him. There was nothing, right? So
yeah.
I just left him, put him back face down.
Yeah.
For, crime scene to get there. And the family starts showing up.
Oh,
you know, his ex-wife.
That's terrible.
Yeah, they're like, oh, falling down on the ground,
that's
crying
terrible.
And shit. It's sad. So at the time Sarge was on scene, I'm like, his ex-wife and his kids want to see the body.
Yeah.
They want to say goodbye or whatever. And he's like, I don't care. It's not no sin. He was like, did, crime scene come out? I'm like, yeah, there's no sin, foul play, blah, blah, blah. So they go back there and it's an apartment, one bedroom apartment. So as he goes to the back room, they're like, whoa, they're
what
like,
the fuck?
I was like, what the fuck?
What?
I don't know. I was like, it wasn't that bad. And they were like, no. And the son's like, mom, no. Like pulling the mom away.
What the fuck?
And they were like, what is that? And I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Like, what? He was just face down. I don't understand. So I'm like, everyone out. So Sarge is looking at me like, the fuck's going on? I'm like, I don't know. So we pull everyone in the hallway. We go in there. Fucking dude, CSI flipped this guy over.
Oh, no.
And left him uncovered.
No.
Bro, he's face up. On his back,
on
the fucking bed, all the blood, he was naked, all the blood pooled to his fucking schlong, and his balls were the size of a fucking watermelon.
Oh, no.
And I was like, what the fuck is that? I was like, holy shit. So I had to throw the blanket over it. And I'm like, no wonder. This guy's got a fucking pumpkin between his legs.
His family
filled with blood. Yeah, they saw. That was the last thing they saw of him. Thank you. And I had no idea. I thought he would have just left him the same way we found him. What the fuck, dude?
CSI does shit like that.
He's like, good to go. Meanwhile, this guy's got a fucking dude, the size of a water. I'm not even joking. I was like, holy shit. Fucking elephantitis, dude. Times 10.
I got to tell you about this one time. I had just gotten promoted. I had to have been in the first 2 weeks I was promoted. And an emergency tone goes out for a suicide. And terrible. I never understand it. But we get there, young lady in her 20s. She jumped from the 12th floor.
Shit.
And she landed feet first on the pavement. And officer that worked for me, he's doing CPR on her. She's clearly dead because her brains are coming out of her head. And he's doing CPR on her. And I look down, and when she landed on her feet, it just shattered everything. Yeah. Like it just
the impact.
Blew her, yeah. her yeah. sneakers apart and everything.
Shit.
So yeah, it was terrible. So we get her, take her to the emergency room where CSI meets us, and they put a sheet over her out of respect. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So they close the curtains in the trauma room. CSI mm-hmm. shows up and the blanket's on him. I'm the sergeant with the officer. I got to stand there and watch while he's taking pictures, because mm-hmm. until we release the body to the coroners,
yeah,
we're on
chain of custody.
Right.
Yep.
So CSI comes, he undoes the blanket from her face. An older CSI doesn't work for us anymore. Super respectful. He takes the picture. He takes the blanket off of her face and he starts talking to her. He's like, I'm sorry. Sorry that you did this to yourself. Yeah, just super, super wow. spiritual. Really choked me up until wow. the next part. And he's like, just explaining to the body what he's going to do. He's like, I'm going to take a couple of pictures of you. I'm going to cover you back up. And then I hope you're at peace. And wow. I thought that was super respectful, because I've never seen any CSI do that before. That either. So this is where it goes downhill, is he grabs the blanket and he starts taking it off. And the blanket gets hung up on her foot. And he whips it real quick to kind of, you know, loosen it.
No.
And the foot and the sneaker, the foot is in the sneaker, flies off.
Oh, no.
And goes across the room in the ER.
Oh, shit.
So there's a foot
inside
of a sneaker.
Rolling across the emergency room. Holy shit.
So I look at him and I go, his name. You got to go get that. Like, you can't just leave that there. Yeah. He's like, I'll get it after I take pictures. I go,
No,
you need to get that now.
Yeah.
So he goes over there, grabs it by the shoelace, and just puts it on her, like, on her thighs.
Oh,
and like just covers her back up after he takes his pictures. The most nastiest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Dude.
Nasty.
Yeah. I don't like those. I don't do that, man. You give me gangbang shootings all day long.
I don't like death.
Stabbings.
Yeah.
Dead bodies. I was actually in the, I was at the ER, you know what I mean? Our emergency. And then it was like the, where they put all the bodies.
I can't even think about it. Oh, shoot.
The ice box.
Yeah, whatever it's called. The corner, the morgue.
Yeah, but
the morgue
inside the hospital.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the morgue room.
Yeah.
And I was like, I went in there and they had like,
it was something,
I don't remember. It was like a 99-year-old lady passed away or whatever. And they put her in there. And I looked down at my phone and I'm like, oh, I have service. I thought this would be a dead zone.
Oh, right.
And they were like, that's not funny at all.
Wow.
And I was like 23 years old. I thought it was hilarious. Yeah. And they were like, that's not funny at all. Like, don't say that. I was like, they were dead serious. Oh, wow. I was like, oh, shit. Sorry. My bad.
Jeez.
Too soon?
Like, that joke died.
Yeah.
Nothing? That's fucking terrible, bro. I got to be honest. If I was there, I would have laughed.
I know. I thought it was gold. And they were like, absolutely not. That's inappropriate. Show some respect. I was like, all right, fucking relax.
There was a period of time when I was a sergeant, when I was on daylights, that I got like two a week of DOAs and just, I don't like it. And I've gotten some really, really weird ones. Like, the weird part is figuring out what happened just before they passed.
Yeah.
That's the weird part, because you're intruding in their lives at the end of their life. Yeah. And you're in a room that these people, this is the last thing that they saw.
Well, it makes you think like how you want to go.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, shit.
I can tell you, I don't want to go.
Are in their sleep.
Yeah.
They're like at rest. you know, and it's all death is always sad. Like there's, it's sad for anyone. It's sad for us.
There's quite a few that I wish I know for a fact that I don't want to go out like they went.
Oh yeah. Like, yeah. Yeah.
I had a guy, it was daylights. His best friend found him. He was using painkillers as through a suppository.
Oh, so shit.
Anally. And he put too many up there and he OD'd. And he was live streaming or Facebook living with somebody. And then he passed and that person just was like, hey, I guess he just went to sleep. So I'm just going to log off. And when we got there, he was taking a machine gun magazine and pleasuring himself through
the
back door.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like a 30 round magazine?
Yes. Fully loaded.
Like just 762 rounds?
Taking it and like, obviously.
Are you making this shit up?
I swear, dude, I swear to you. He wasn't getting it in the fucking tunnel.
Dude.
But he was like using it as like a credit card slot. Like he was sliding it up and down in there and he died. Like, I guess he got so like amped up that he, why are you laughing? It was really nasty because we had to collect that magazine.
So wait a minute. He didn't have the chip. Like the new credit card, the chip you insert it. And it
didn't have that back then.
He had to swipe.
You know what's nasty? You're laughing, but you know what's nasty is we had to actually put gloves on and one by one take out the 223 rounds to make sure that none of them were stuck inside of him.
Oh my gosh!
And those rounds,
disgusting.
They taste. They smelt like shit. I almost said they tasted like shit.
So CSI came out. Let me process this.
No, they made us. They were like, did you guys count the rounds to make sure that nothing's left internally?
Yeah.
And we were like, the what?
Yeah.
And they were like, yeah. Yeah. That's.
I had a guy who they thought he was a DOA dead on arrival. And they called and the lady was worried about her son. Mm-hmm. And the fire department breaches the door. 2-bedroom apartment, huge apartment in high rise. I'm calling this guy's name, I'm like, you know, and the fire department's like hanging back as usual.
Yeah.
Well, we're back here. Let us know.
I gotta wait for it to be safe.
And
we got fire personnel that listens to this, but you're going to abandon every fucking listener.
Hey, I love the fire department. I love you guys. You know, keep the chili's great.
Yeah. When they wake up, they're going to listen to this.
So, yeah, exactly. So I'm like, hey, calling this guy's name and nothing. Right. So I go back there. The guy's in the middle of a fucking jack session, bro.
What?
I breach the door. And he's going to town.
No.
And he's like, oh, gosh. And I'm like, hey, what the fuck? Dude, show me your hands, dude. And he throws his hands up.
I don't think I want to see.
Dude, he had like paper, like napkins all over.
Oh, he
had the porn going, dude.
Candle? Oh, yeah. Candle?
No candle. It smelled like fucking wet ass in there. It was disgusting.
Oh, come on.
I was like, come on, dude. Can you put something on? And he was like, oh, so I guess he had it so high turned up. He didn't hear us banging on the door.
Because he was banging.
Oh, yeah. He was. Man, he was assault and battering himself. Yeah,
he was committing a homicide on his on his penis.
First 48.
Yeah. Yeah. Strangulation. You had to take his penis for a sane exam.
And I'm like, what are you doing? Like, come on, man. Answer your phone. That's you got your mom trying nasty. To get a hold of you. We're banging. We just breached the door. You didn't hear us come in here?
That's nasty.
And he was like, oh, sorry, sir. He was like 22-year-old kid or whatever.
What the fuck, bro?
Yeah, welcome to our world. That's police, man. They need that shit on live PD.
No, they would never, bro. They'd cut to a commercial. I did see on live PD one time that they had an actual police shooting on there, which was like,
yeah, that's crazy.
My mouth was open. I was like, what? Yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah.
What other crazy ones have you had, bro?
I don't know, man. I don't. Those are pretty much the top ones for now.
For now,
you know, they ebb and flow. You know how it is. Sometimes you'll just be sitting in there doing nothing at home, and then it's just like, oh yeah,
It'll come out of nowhere. You're just like,
I remember that. Yeah, that was hilarious.
Yeah, you know? It wasn't at the time though. Like you're like, fuck.
I'm telling you, dude. I hate DOAs, dude. There was one more. So we went, and it was real sad. The guy had, you know, he talked to his kid every day. Guy's in his 60s. You know, son was maybe 21. And he's like, yeah, it was a basement level apartment and like a garden style. And they get in there and one of our guys tried to breach the door, but he couldn't get in. So we fire department came in, they breached it and they get back there. Guy's like 500 pounds.
Oh, no.
Like gigantic.
Dead?
Oh yeah, face first in the bed.
Oh,
massive. Like he had like a breathing machine, like an oxygen tank and shit. On the low end, 500 pounds.
Oh.
So of course, how the hell are they gonna? It's a garden style. Like you can't open the wall and get a fucking U-Haul and a forklift. You know what I'm saying?
How the fuck did they get him out?
That's what I'm saying. So, and I was a sergeant. Thank God.
Thank God.
Yes.
That shit would have landed.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
So I was like, the guy shows up. So he's like, older guy shows up from the body removal. And typically it's like two guys in a suit show up, right?
This one guy showed up?
No, it was one guy in the in one van. And then he was like, oh, let me see what assessing.
Yeah.
Because we told him like, this guy's pretty big. So code you're going to need reinforcements.
Code red. Yeah.
So the guy shows, he's like, so he gets on the phone. He's like, this motherfucker's like 700 pounds. Like the weight just keeps going up. You know what I mean? We're going to need like eight people out here, you know? And he's like, they're like, well, how many you got? You know, because he got on speaker. And he's like, I got one, two. I was like, nope. I'm not picking up that body. Absolutely not. You better get more people out here.
Yeah.
No. So anyway, they start to... You know, they get them out and they're doing a really great job of this, actually getting them out, getting them going, and they start to slide them because they have like a duffel bag, you know, because they can't get the gurney down there. So they have to put them like in this, you know, the plastic bag with the handles on the side. And there's like six guys.
It's literally struggling.
And because the hallway's so small, it's an apartment and it's a garden, you know, so they had to get them up the steps.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting in the back just watching, you know, his son and his ex-wife are out and they're crying and, you know, it's fucking sad. You know? And they got him covered up, and the guy's like at the bottom, and he's like, come on, man, this motherfucker's big as shit. You know, like they're like pushing him up. Oh. And then all the shit falls out of his ass at the same time.
Oh,
it's
dude.
Just like, you know,
what the?
And the guy's like, hold on. He's like, hold on. He's like, I got shit on my fucking face. He's got shit all down his hand, dude. He drops the body back down the stairs to like the base of the fucking. And I'm like, come on, man. He's like, man, fuck you. I'm not picking this shit up. Like, he wanted to quit right then.
Holy shit.
He was like, I can't. The dude was sweating profusely, bro.
Dude, he's never going to get that smell off of his hand.
I mean, it was all over it. And then he was like, give me some wipes.
It's like fucking Thanos glove full of shit.
Dude, they started bringing people with wipes and shit. And they were throwing them like
wipes.
Whole,
yeah. Fucking gasoline.
Dude, it was bad.
Oh, that's.
And they finally got him. You know, and they got him on the gurney and got him
out. That's
I was
nasty.
Like crying, laughing, dude. I was like, holy shit. He was like, come on, man, help us out. I was like, no, hell
no.
No,
no way.
No, I'm not touching that, dude.
Not for what I get paid.
What are you taking this to?
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
As we watched our nation's first responders suffer, our team decided to take a stand. We formed the Araya Guardian Foundation Incorporated to provide real solutions to the mental health epidemic that is plaguing the men and women in uniform every day. With the war on police, lack of training, weak leadership, and poor morale, our responders are suffering on multiple levels. The mission of the Araya Guardian Foundation Incorporated is to provide programs and assistance to our men and women at any cost. We will only grow with the help of our community members' generous donations. Please visit tagfink.com, tagfinc.com, to make your donation now. Be their first responder. They need you now more than ever. Save their lives because they would save yours. Visit tagfink.com to make your donation and help support the mission.
All right, we're back from break.
All right. Welcome back.
Great story, Mike. Great.
Yeah.
Story.
So back to the topic at hand that we
was trying so hard to avert you from your topic.
And I was like, man, we mentioned it earlier in the show. You might as well finish out.
Yeah, I was like, you just asked how much time we had left in the episode. And you were like, all right, we're going to hit it.
So we get a call for a domestic. Nice, really nice neighborhood. Actually, I've probably never even been back to this neighborhood in our area since this call. And get there, and there's two older guys, probably in their 50s, and they're a gay couple. They've been together, married, and the guy's like very, very distraught. You know what I'm saying? Boy. Like extremely emotional. And I'm like, whoa, he's like, I guess the other guy was cheating or whatever. And we have to investigate if an assault and battery has occurred, right? Domestic. And someone's got to go to jail. Someone puts hands on somebody.
Yeah.
And they're the aggressor. You got to go.
Yeah.
So get out, get to this, me and another guy, go back there, you know, maybe we'll find the other party. He's in the back bedroom crying. Right. Okay. So we go, it's like the low lighting in the house, beautiful house, mm-hmm. you know, we start to go back there. The guy's, you know, on the bed, shit. And as soon as we go in the room, dude, they have this fucking trophy case of dildos.
Come on. Like, come on.
They had like this stand up contraption. And the I was like, what the fuck is that? I mean,
were you at Andy Dick's house?
I've heard that name in years. And I was like, wow. So anyways, we get out and whatever. And then I tell the other officer, I'm like, hey, did you collect that thing? And he was like, huh? And I'm like, you need it for processing. He was like, what thing? I'm like, did they go back in there and look, you know? Oh. So we start sending guys, the rookie back there to go get it. And then it just says it on his face when he comes back. He's like, why'd you do that?
You're a fucking asshole.
You asshole. Then we had another one.
I'm starting to worry about you that you have stories.
The thing is, where I got the idea from is that like these TikTok videos where these people are like putting dildos at like high to reach places.
Yes.
And then they can't get to them. Yes. And then the kids film it in school. That shit's hilarious. You've seen them?
Yes.
They're fucking hilarious.
Yes. Yes.
Or like they're slapping it with a broom and it's like this big dong flapping around.
So now you're heavy
around.
Into TikTok?
No, it was just one thing.
Oh, okay.
I'm not
you're
a big
anti-TikTok.
TikTok. I'm not a TikTok guy. They're vines. It's the same thing.
Yeah, but
it's the
a
same
twist.
Thing as vines.
There's a twist.
I don't know. Anyway, so yeah, so I was like, that's hilarious. You know, I saw that video. I was like, that shit's hilarious. You know, it's some shit I would have did in high school.
Oh,
a
absolutely.
Big dong up there on the clock in the gym, and then the guy slapping it, trying to get it down.
Absolutely.
So we made it. I was like, oh, that could be, you know, material, you know, fucking dildos. We see them all the time at work, you know, in the most oddest times. This is fucking hilarious. So I had another one. So it was fairly recent. Me and DC, the guy who's about to retire.
Yeah.
We go to this one and, you know, he's, you know, been on the job forever or whatever. And he goes up there. And as a gay couple, two guys together, they're like, one guy assaulted the other one or whatever. And they're like an emotional, you know, big, you know, when he went out of town, he cheated, whatever. Mm. So he's like, can I get a couple of my things? Right. I'm like, yeah, sure. No problem. Get some of your property. So we're in there, we're standing by the boyfriend. He's like, can I talk to you in the back room? I'm like, sure. So I go, he's like, yeah, you know, he's hit me before. And I'm like, all right, where? He was like, when we were in DC, whatever, whatever, whatever. So we come out. And the guy was like, you got all your stuff, right? You ready to go? He's like, yeah, I think I got everything. Nice guy. And he was like, no, he forgot something. So he goes in the back room, dude.
Oh, boy.
And gets this. He comes out and he throws this thing. And it looked like a snake.
Come on.
Like, you know, that you pull out of the. It was like something that you pull out of the. You know, when you're washing your dishes. The retractable thing to like wash your pots and shit. Put it back in the thing, the holder.
Yeah.
And that's what it looked like. I was like, what the fuck is that? And then the guy was like, come on, that's inappropriate. And I'm like, yeah, he's right. That is inappropriate. But like me and DC are laughing.
Fucking laughing.
Like laughing our ass.
I could just
I'm like, all right, come on. Enough.
I could just picture
he's like,
that.
This is yours. And throws this thing and it like flaps on the ground. You know, I'm like, what is that thing? You know, it's got like a fucking ripcord to it and shit.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. That shit was crazy.
It's the fucking Woody.
But he took it with him.
Did he?
He was like,
I'll use that.
Yeah, I'm going to take this with me. So he shoves it. So I have one more.
Oh, boy.
So we get a traffic stop in the projects, right? And the guy He's like, thug dude. He's like, yeah, whatever, you know, real disrespectful. But he's, his car smells like dope. I'm like, dude, you got to step out.
Oh, boy.
You know, and, you know, we cuff him up and he's like, I smoked it all, whatever, whatever, whatever. This ain't my car. Sure, this is my cousin's car.
Yeah. These aren't my pants.
Yeah, exactly. So search the car, a little bit of dope, whatever. And bingo, bingo, winner, winner, chicken dinner under the driver's seat, Crown Royal bag.
Oh, boy.
So I thought, I was like, all right. So I go inside the Crown, and of course I have my gloves on, always do, as you should.
Always.
So I go inside the Crown Royal bag. I'm like, what the hell is this? And I pull out this massive fucking dildo.
Oh, God.
Inside the Crown Royal bag.
What?
Yeah. I was like, what is this?
Did you smell it?
No.
Okay.
So I take it. This is daylight. So it's like 10 a.m. There's like four cops there. No.
Okay.
So I take it out and I smack it on the hood of the car. And I'm like, hey, you got a concealed carry permit for this? And the guy's like, oh, come on, man. Put that shit away. Why you do me like that? And I'm like, what is this thing? He's like, come on, man. Chill out. Chill out. Chill out. He's like, that's my girls. That's my girls.
Sure,
I thought this was your cousin's car.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, he's like, man, chill out with that shit.
Why does it say Steve on the bottom of
Steve.
It?
Steve.
Fucking hilarious. I had one. I was on nights and this lady came home from work and she heard somebody upstairs in her bedroom and she did the right thing. She called 911. She left. She waited for us outside. I get there. Another office doesn't work for us anymore. She's like, you know, you can go in. Canine's not available. So we go in. We start search. Like, as soon as I walk in, I hear movement upstairs and search the whole bottom. You know, clear, clear, clear.
Yeah.
Go up the stairs. It's getting louder and I get up there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I get up there and, all bedrooms are clear, except I go into the master bedroom and I hear it and it's coming from a closet and we're fucking just amped up, you know, gone out, fucking open up the drawer, open up the closet and you could hear it in the closet and there's nobody in there. So now I'm like, what the fuck? So gloved up, I go in and in a bag was a dildo going off.
Flapping around.
I guess like there was like some sort of battery feature on there when it's low battery that it kicks on. I don't know what the fuck was going on.
Auto.
But you want to talk about embarrassing.
Oh, man.
We played rock, paper, scissors. Who was going to tell her?
Yeah.
Embarrassing. Totally embarrassing. Because I went down and she's like, is everything okay? Did somebody break in? And I was like, no. Nobody broke in. And she's like, what was it? And I was like, well, you may need to change the batteries in the thing that we found in your closet. Good night, officers. Just like that, bro.
You didn't say anything on the air like, I found the culprit.
No.
Not touching that.
No, I didn't have any time on it that time, bro. I was new.
That's fucking hilarious.
All right. That wraps it up.
We'll be back.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, check us out at rollcallroom.com.
Ready or not.
Check us out on Twitter at rollcallroom. Like us, spread the message. Go on iTunes. We are now available on iTunes. We are under the Roll Call Room. Check out our podcast. Rate us and share. Be safe. Watch your six. And as always, always off the rip.
Those who correlate know the world ain't kick. Jail bars ain't golden gates. Those who fake, they break. When they meet their 400-pound mate, if I could rule the world, everyone would have a gun in the ghetto, of course. When get the up and on their horse. Kick around, drinking moonshine. I pour a sip on the concrete for the deceased. But no, don't weep. Why Clef's in a state of sleep, thinking about the robbery that I did last week. Money in the bag, banker look like a...
All right, fans, thanks so much for tuning in to another great episode of the Roll Call Room. I want to remind you that we are on YouTube. Go on our YouTube channel and subscribe. We're also on Twitter at Roll Call Room. We're also on Facebook at Roll Call Room Podcast. We're also on Instagram. We're always asking for you guys to go on iTunes and rate us a 5-star with a comment. Helps us climb the charts. Don't forget to check out bluehelp.org. If you're struggling out there and you need somebody to talk to, we'd highly recommend them. Don't forget about our nonprofit, tagfink.com. We got some great shows coming up soon, and we love hearing from you guys. So please email us at nick@rollcallroom.com or mike@rollcallroom.com. And always take care of each other, look out for each other, and check on each other.